Welcome to Elite Wine TV. I'm your host, Mark Fusco, here for another episode of the show. And, all right, so now, a little bit going up, we're going down or up the list. This is going to be the most expensive of, at least retail, I think actually, and the most expensive of all the wines I'm doing in this group of wines. This is one of the big boys, one of the ones that everybody knows, one of the names that you see in the wine list, you go, ooh, and I've never had this wine, so I'm really excited to try it. This is the 2007 Stag's Leap Merlot Napa Valley. All right, this wine can be had for $27.77 at Specs. Good thing you had $27.77 at Specs. Let me start the timer. I forgot to do that. Come on. On their website, you can buy it for $32 a bottle. And at a restaurant, it's going to cost you, say around... sorry, I got distracted on some stuff here. It's going to cost you around $60 to $70 a bottle. That's some good juice right there, right? So, and you can expect the restaurant to pay about the same retail, probably around $26, $27 maybe. They may pay a little bit less, but probably not too much less than what you're paying at the grocery store, or probably not the grocery store, well, nice grocery store maybe, but at the liquor store. So I'm actually looking up, about right, $26, $27. They might pay a little bit less, maybe 25, maybe pay like 28. But, I think I already did that, didn't I? All you people are probably going, oh my God, he's pouring out great wine. All right, now I know it's all been thing. All right, so Stag's Leap. Let's talk about Stag's Leap for a second here. Stag's Leap is a winery. It's also an appellation. It's one of those weird ones, right? So the Stag's Leap appellation is in the Napa Valley. This appellation for this wine is Napa Valley. So I don't know if maybe they are wanting to use the wider appellation of Napa Valley because not everything is coming from Stag's Leap AVA specifically, or they want to reserve using the Stag's Leap AVA for their higher end wines, because, you know, I don't know. But typically what it means is that the grapes aren't all from Stag's Leap AVA, that they may be getting grapes from outside the AVA itself, that they own some wineries, or maybe they've bought some grapes from somewhere else. That was one of those things where if I thought about it, I would have emailed the winery ahead of time and said, hey, why is it Napa and not Stag's Leap on this bottle? All right, so anyway, let's check it out. Yeah, no fact sheet. Boo. Matter of fact, the amount of information for the particular wine is pretty lacking, other than they've got the little stuff. Oh, by the way, this winery's been around since 1893. So they've been around for a minute. Okay, so I got a bit of smoke in here. Now, for me, this nose is a little bit challenging. I don't get a whole heck of a lot. I'm getting some smoke. Earthiness, but really not much else. This is a wine that potentially I would do better if I had decanted it as soon as I opened it. The decanter, oh, you can't see it because it's way off to the side now. Moved it. I will decant some kind of wine eventually. But yeah, really not much else. I mean, I get the smoky. I like my smell, but it's not like, it's not wowing me. There's no wow factor for me. Guys, just check out the taste. Palette is much better than the bouquet, in my opinion. IMHO, in my humble opinion. This is good. This is really good wine. I like it. Like savoring it. Tannins. Let's talk about the tannins real quick. The tannins just are gentle. Is I think how I would put it. They're not overpowering. They're not taking over my mouth. It's a fuller wine than all the other ones. Not significantly fuller, but it's fuller. It's got some fruit. And it's got a little bit of dust to it. So I feel it's got a good balance of fruit and minerality to it. Again, that's how my palate perceives it. The finish is I would say medium length. See, now I'm starting to get into, okay, let's talk about some other stuff on here because I'm getting better wines, you know, higher quality wines, and like, yeah, it's pretty tasty, you know, drink it, you know. I'd say it's medium finish. Gonna have to empty that soon because, one, you're probably hearing all the bloop. It's a good even palate. It's nothing. It doesn't like disappear in the middle. The finish is decent. It's good. You want to shell out $25 to $30 for a bottle of wine at the grocery store or at the higher end grocery store, the liquor store, get it. It's tasty. It's definitely oak influence. It's got some of that creaminess to it. Cherries. I'd say cherries and a little bit of cream. A little vanilla. Definitely vanilla. It's got just a touch of earthiness, a little bit of dust for me. So it's got that nice little play because I kind of like that stuff. But you know, cherry pie-like. Maybe, I don't know why I just thought about rhubarb. I have no idea what rhubarb tastes like, but for some reason, rhubarb pie came to mind. Maybe I need to try some rhubarb pie soon so I know whether I'm tasting that or not. Yeah, the cherries, and then on the tail end, more the earthiness, the dust. Nice big steak. This is a good steak wine. Definitely, I would recommend this. If you're out somewhere and you want to drop $60 to $70 for a bottle at the restaurant, kind of, you know, impress people, because you know it's going to be a good bottle of wine. This is not going to be a bottle of wine you're going to be like, well, I don't know. It's going to be good. Buy it. Especially if you were trying to impress your girl or you've got the boss at the table and you want to go, oh, Stag's Leap, it's good. Well, it is. Buy it. And again, for you know, at the house, if you can shell out the $25 to $30 it's going to cost you, or more, maybe even $35 depending on where you're buying it from, $32 from the thing. If you got that kind of money, and I don't make it want to sound like it's $100 bottle of wine, but if that's in your budget, as far as like a regular wine purchase, do it. If you want to buy like you know, like a special bottle. You know, you see, have your $10 bottles, but if you want something a little bit special for like a nicer dinner at home, buy it. This is not a wine I probably would want to drink on its own. I probably want to have it with some food. Yeah, absolutely. All right, so this is the fourth wine of the restaurant series of wines. I have another 30 to go. At some point in time, I'll get them all done. But this is going to be great because a lot of these wines are ones I want to try that I've seen on wine lists, and I'm like, let's do it. Because these are kind of the wines that people know and helps my experience. Other than that, I hope everyone's having a great whatever day of the week it is. Hope your week's been great. Hope your weekend was awesome. Hope you have a great weekend coming up. Memorial Day weekend has already happened. So hopefully you had a great time. You barbecued. Maybe you had that Blackstone with the barbecue. Hopefully you had the day off on Monday. If you didn't, I feel you because, you know, I'm in the industry. You know, I'm in one of those industries that work 7 days a week. So not work, but open 7 days a week. So I understand. But then again, guess what? Off Wednesday and Thursday or Tuesday, you know, off when the rest of people are working. Hopefully you've had a wonderful week already or a wonderful weekend, and we'll see everybody again next time.